That's a real place, and that's in a souk in Jordan. And they were selling Indian trinkets and headdresses.
In an Arab country.
I was seeing Choctaw people in the lower Mississippi Valley in 1738. Smallpox blankets arrived in the east and were traded west, along with the smell of oblivion. Gifts from hairy-fingered foreigners. I was seeing our warriors fall and get up, then walk through a door that centuries later I would emerge from, my fist clenched at birth, screaming, "Who wants to fight?" I grew up listening to the most amazing stories. My grandmother was a storyteller. I'll give you an example. This is in the 40s. These three Indians with blankets around them were walking on the side of the road. And as they got closer and closer, they thought, oh, we could stop and give them a ride. And they disappeared right before their very eyes. Just like that. So as a little kid, I heard that story repeated again and again, and sometimes with different details. And for me, hearing those kind of stories, which I hold a lot of the stories for our family, made me want to be a writer. And I wanted to tell stories about our people, our tribes, our land, what had happened to us. And that's what I did. Essentially, like all writers, I'm in the room by myself, yet in the process of writing there are, you know, sometimes hundreds of people in the room. They're certainly my characters. And what I try to access as a writer in telling these stories is follow those characters throughout a landscape, throughout their lives. So I get a lot of energy from writing fiction that I probably don't in other genres. But fiction gives an American Indian writer, I think, or all writers, a depth of experience. You have to know things, but you have to find out what you don't know about this particular character. So I'm always adding to my knowledge base just by writing fiction. What I get out of writing poetry is I have to teach myself kind of the song or the refrain that's in poetry. That is a different process than necessarily writing fiction. So I get song, I get meter, I get images. You know, I'm trying to produce images in poetry that are a little bit different than in writing fiction. At the same time, I like meshing them, kind of a mashup in my longer fiction will contain poetry as well. But I use a different part of my brain. Indigenous writers or American Indian writers, Native writers, have challenges that they have to face. I think as writers, we tend to include what I would call a tribalography of stories, which involve landscape, people, all peoples. You must write through some of the challenges that people don't know about your community. So that's unique, I think, to various writers of color. What do Native writers do that's different? We're writing tribalography, which is linking one thing to another in our stories. The past, present, the future are all kind of coexist in really great Native writing. I like the mashup and the freedom to weave a story as it needs to be woven. So yes, I do a lot of research. I write a lot. I take notes. I listen for sounds. I try to incorporate all that into a work that's living on the page.